people are fine with downloading a 5 gigabyte movie. You know what I mean? They're just going to do that. And they know where that's going to live, and they know how it's going to get off of their device. People are not fine with downloading that size of an app, because apps live in a different place. They're more obtrusive in that they sit on the desktop of your device, and it feels weird. Like, you don't have a movie sitting on the desktop of your that's not even the right word for it, but on the main screen of your device. So just the way these things, this is just basic user interaction. There's a weirdness to the way this kind of app works in the way people organize the way they navigate through their devices. Because these things are like movies or books, but they don't live in a place like movies or books live. So I think it's a tough thing for people to wrap their heads around. Even if people can easily wrap their heads around that intellectually, but just in terms of actual practice, it's awkward. That could change tomorrow. You know what I mean? That could change that could change very quickly, and suddenly all of this could be very viable. I don't regret anything about having done this, because eventually this will all be viable.
You're getting at something very interesting, which is, how do you categorize stuff? Because when you can categorize, you can assign value, expectation. I mean, God, I'd love to put Ajax in any digital bookstore, because people will pay $7 on average for a PDF for a digital book without batting an eye. And it's like, it's text. You know, from a resource standpoint, it's like a fraction of the energy we expended. But, it categorizes as well, like you said. And I think it's going to fall in two ways. I think that, first of all, I can't wait for the App Store to become obsolete. I'll just say that right now. But you're right. I mean, being able to put, having savvy web-based technology that works just as well on mobile as it does on desktop, it's going to happen eventually. And I can't wait as a media creator. But we're not there yet. And then the other side that's going to happen is some sort of understanding and language around whatever these experimental book, filmy, gamey things are that don't fit neatly into any category. And by calling it an app, you're putting it into the same space as freemium 99-cent crap that we distract ourselves with on our phones all the time. And it's a totally different attention economy and expectation of value by consumers. Apps go obsolete all the time. My biggest fear is that iOS 9 or whatever is going to come out and my app won't run anymore and I'm done. Like, what am I going
to
do?
You do need durability so that you can continue to point activists to the right resources. And I think that's, again, another reason why we did look at a web-based solution versus something else, because we could archive it on our own website. We can continue to point people there as long as it's a viable issue.
It's the problem filmmaker space times 100. Probably in another 2 years, Vision Machine will no longer work on an iPad. You know what I mean? They're going to upgrade in a certain way. It's going to break something, and it just won't work. And I don't have the budget to upgrade it. Which means that it will disappear unless I have found other ways to put the material out in different ways. But that's a big problem.